Hey y'all, this is Church from Church's Intake. Let's get into the reading of his word. 1 Peter chapter 4, 1 through 11. God's stewards, good stewards of God's grace. Let's do it. For as much then as Christ had suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves likewise with the same mind. For he that hath suffered in the flesh hath ceased from sin, that he no longer should live the rest of his time in the flesh to the lusts of men, but to the will of God. For in times past of our life may suffice us to have wrought the will of the Gentiles, when we walk in lasciviousness, lust, excess of wine, revels, banquetings, and abominable idolatries, wherein they think it strange that ye run not with them to the same excess of riot, speaking evil of you, who shall give account to him that is ready to judge the quick and the dead. For this cause was the gospel preached unto also to them that are dead, that they might be judged according to the man in the flesh, but living according to God in the spirit. But the end of all things is at hand. But be ye therefore sober and watch unto prayer, and above all things have fervent charity among yourselves, for charity shall cover the multitude of sins. Use hospitality one to another without grudging, as every man hath received the gift, even so minister the same one to another, as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. If any man speak, let him speak as the oracle of God. If any man minister, let him do it as of the ability which God giveth, that God in all things may be glorified through Jesus Christ, to whom be praise and dominion for ever and ever. God bless the reading of his word. I butchered that a little bit too. I always be butchering up the word a little bit. But let's get into the word. So he was talking about charity. He was saying we need to live in the spirit and you die to your flesh. So when you die to your flesh, obviously you have to have a different mindset. Once you die to your flesh, you have to be in a spiritual sense, in a spiritual mindset, because you're not of your flesh. And the things of the flesh is lust, drinking, you know, just doing worldly things, you know what I mean, like the normal people do. And he says the Gentiles, so the people of the world, technically, you know what I'm saying? Obviously, we know the Jews and the Gentiles, but we don't even want to get in specifics. We're just saying people of the world, you got to separate yourself from those type of people and those type of mindsets, because you want to live a spiritual life. And you can't live a spiritual life if you still in the old mindset of your carnal mind thinking. And he's talking about charity and love. And you have to lead with love and charity to others to show them that, yes, you do have God's grace on you. You do work in God's, you know, kingdom. And the way that you work with God's in God's kingdom is with love, loving one another, showing mercy to others, you know, trying to help lift them up. You know what I mean? And navigate them to the right way, to the right path of God, which is love kills all things, you know what I mean? All evil things. So anybody that's working in these evil mindsets, evil iniquities, wanting to do things to other people, like, that's not of God, and those are not the people of God. Like, you carry this on you, so it's not something that you can really hide. There's a lot of people that hide the way that they truly believe and think, you know, and you can tell by the way that they talk about people or the way they act towards another. Like, you can tell me that you a child of God, right? But you always mad and you seem mean and you hateful about different things. So you know those aren't the operations of God, you know what I mean? You know they're working out of their iniquities, like they have some type of jealousy on them or some type of, you know what I mean, some type of something that is preventing them to operate out of the spirit. And the spirit is love and faith, you know what I mean? They have to have faith of whatever trials and tribulations that they're going through. They have to have the faith that God told them that whatever they're going through, that they're going to get through it. And if these people don't, you know, walk in that type of move, then you know these people aren't the real ones of Christ. Because a person in Christ, yeah, you can get weak in your faith, but you still have the ultimate faith, believing that God's going to take you out of any position that you're in. And you're supposed to show love to even your haters. You know what I'm saying? You love them, but you can love them from a distance too. Like, you don't have to, you forgive them. Like, if they came up to you and said, I was doing this, that, and the third about you, you know what I mean? You got to use your senses, you know what I'm saying? To be like, okay, was it something that could really take me out or whatever? You're supposed to forgive them and you're supposed to love them, you know what I mean? And forgive them so you don't have sins on yourself. But once you do this, it's like you have to set up barriers for some. And some of them you can, you know, I'll forgive you, brother, but I can't be with you like we used to be. It's not the same type of deal. But that's not saying that you don't love these people and you don't want them to change. Obviously, they're coming to you with their heart. And you know what I mean? Like, they're bringing out their pride. They're coming out of their pride to tell you what they've been doing behind your back. So you're supposed to forgive them and you're supposed to still love them. And you ain't supposed to hate on them for whatever they did. But obviously, you're going to have to set certain boundaries for certain people depending on what they did to you in your life. And you still got to show them love, even though they might hate you. You know what I'm saying? You're still supposed to show them love, but you can love them from a distance. You know what I'm saying? And you don't have to be all like, oh, yeah, brother, this, that, and the third. Like, no, you keep up your barriers. I forgive you, brother. I still love you. You know what I mean? I'm going to pray that you even get even better in your walk with Christ. Yeah, maybe me and you might not be able to, you know, go forward and working together or whatever. But at the end of the day, you know, God's going to bring you out of that situation. And I'll pray for you that you continue to get out of that situation and then you keep it moving. You know what I'm saying? You don't always got to like forgive. You don't got to just forgive and bring them back in your good graces like that. That's not what God's saying. He's saying forgive them and let them be free. Because once you forgive them, they are free. So it's like you forgive them, let them be free. And you know what I mean? You can be like, yo, I forgive you and everything. I still love you and everything. You know what I'm saying? But me and you, we just can't be together because there's going to always be something. And that might have to play out like that. And hopefully God brings somebody else around them or whatever, you know what I'm saying, that can help them out. Furthermore, that, you know, you forgave them, but you had to move on because that's not where you at no more. Or you elevated and you just not there no more. You're not into that. So it's just like sometimes you forgive and let go. And some of these people you can work with and some of them, you know, you can't work with. But also, once you forgive these people, you have to bring that up with God as well, because God will let you know if you're supposed to bring these people back or if you're supposed to keep a distance, just praying for them, letting them go and keeping your distance. But you also should just forgive them. Just forgive them for whatever they did, because a lot of people have different things that triggered them to do what they did to you. So make sure that you know that whatever they did, that you have the heart and you have a good heart posture to forgive any and everybody that did you wrong. Now, don't be naive and take people back just because you forgave them and they think they might come back like, oh, we'll be in the same spot. No, that's not it. That's not how you do it. You forgive them and then you let them show themselves to you if they worked into a spot, not just giving people spots. So I'm going to leave that one right there. Subscribe to Church's Intake. God bless.